preview. I don't know, this might be kind of weird, but... Hey! Come here! No, we're bear pickle. Hey, tell him shit pickle. Tell him your name.
Shit
pickle. Yeah, this is shit pickle. Shit pickle. Shit pickle. Shit pickle's gonna help me comment on this game. Now,
shit.
It's kind of a weird one, and hey, shit pickle, you like video games?
Shit pickle.
You like Nintendo? You ever play this game Master Chu and the Drunkard Hu? Yeah. So, yeah, it's a weird game, and you can just tell just by the cartridge. It's one of those weird baby blue cartridges, so you can tell right off the bat that it's a big piece of fucking shit.
The story involves a legendary Siamese twin Shiva from Hindu religion. She has filled the world with evil spirits.
Shit.
Your best friend Master Chu has failed to stop him, and he's resorted to drinking, so now he's a drunk. Now the Master Chu has not given up hope. It's up to him to put an end to the evil Shiva.
Sounds pretty shitty. What do you say, shit pickle?
Shit pickle.
Yeah.
There's really only one reason to buy this game, and that's to be able to say, I own Master Chu and the Drunkard Hu, so people can awkwardly stare at you.
Shit.
Your objective each round is to locate all the yin yang symbols in order to fight the boss.
Shit pickle.
You can shoot energy out of your hand, and you can upgrade to two shots of energy at the same time.
You wanna try, shit pickle?
Shit pickle. So what do you think?
Shit,
exactly. Instead of pressing A or B to jump, like in most games, you have to press up, sort of like in a Karate Kid.
Shit.
Maybe the control's so shitty because the programmers were trying to make Chu seem drunk. Or they were drunk themselves.
Shit.
There's endless waves of spiders, snakes, and other unnameable things that come after you.
Shit, pickle, shit, pickle, shit, pickle. What are you talking about, Brett?
Shit, pickle.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
The best effect in this game is that when standing still, Chu's clothes wave around in the wind. Now let's talk about the sounds. It sucks.
Shit.
And it's the same for every stage, just stereotypical Chinese music playing over and over in a loop.
Shit, pickle.
So after you beat the first level, the rest of the game is just the same repetitive thing over and over again. I mean, it's more fun taking a shit.
Shit.
Each board, you collect 8 yin yang symbols, you fight the boss, and then you get the key. And by the way, the key in this game is called the Flaming Key of Freedom. Flaming, huh? Kind of like the flame whip in Simon's Quest. The boss fights aren't even challenging because all you have to do is stand on the platform until they turn your back, then you drop down, land a few hits, and then you repeat.
Shit.
For the last boss in the game, Shiva, I was expecting something a little better. I don't know why, but all you get is this weird statue. And why the fuck is it green? I mean, could they have picked another putrid color but green?
Shit.
So after you beat the boss, you get to see the best ending in video game history.